Something you said just there has just been ringing in my ears a little bit, and I was just thinking about whether I thought it was true or not. You said that people don't go to, obviously they don't go to your website for fun. Do you not think there is a demographic of people that do, you know, that phrase property porn, they love looking at property. Do you think that, is what you're saying, that's probably done more on the portals rather than on an agent's own website? Are you saying when they go to an agent's website, they're much more deliberate in what they're intending to do?
Well, generally, if you think about sort of like the reasons why someone would go onto an estate agent website, and you can look at the journey as well, you know, people start with their so-called research phase. Yep. So I am considering selling my property at some point. And because I'm considering, I'm probably now starting to listen more about what's the market doing. I'm checking perhaps other properties on the market to see what price I should expect for my property. I'm starting to read articles about when is the best time to sell, probably more about sales progression, stamp duty, all kinds of things like this. This is the research phase, and this is where people will end up on your blog articles and will consume blogs. But that's because they have a particular intent, right? I wouldn't sort of wake up one day and think, oh, I know what, I'm bored, I'm going to go on to an estate agent website. That's never going to happen. But it can happen if I'm into music, into fashion, into art, you know. So it's a different sort of intent. So this is why with estate agent, everything should start with your buyer's persona you're looking to attract. That's your starting point. Who are you looking to attract with your website? Then you structure your content to ensure that those people have the best possible journey on your website. So blogs, yes, they are for that research sort of phase. Once I move on to my next phase of the journey where I'm thinking, right, now I've decided I am going to put my property on the market, I will sell, then I'm going to start researching which estate agent am I going to invite to my house. Is it this one? Is it this one? Or is it this one? In which case, at that point, the kind of content I'll be looking at is maybe social proof, case studies. You know, are the Google reviews 5 stars? Are people complaining from this agent or that agent? And based on this type of content, I will decide which 3 perhaps I will invite to my house. So you can see that the content on the website is very much about the journey and which phase of the journey the customer is in. But yep. You need to have it all. You need to have the research phase type content. You need to have, that's called the top of the funnel, middle of the funnel, which is where I'm researching the different agents. And then bottom of the funnel is where you have the calls to action, such as book a valuation, book a consultation. So you're trying to progress them to actually take action and sort of go to their home to value the property and hopefully get the instruction.